I didn't restart the audio, so my mic wasn't going to work. Welcome in, SW. Hopefully you're having a great day. That's six, right? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, give or take number. But welcome in. It is good day. That is good to hear. We're going to be coding some. Where's Waruto? Oh, there it is. Okay. We're just going to be messing around, relaxing with coding. And then, give or take in a little bit, we'll actually be playing Fortnite with, you know, depending on how she's feeling. So we're on functional programming within Python, and we gotta write out stuff using the intersection method to be able to calculate two sets. Welcome in, Waffle. Congratulations on second redeem and 19th daily reward, as well as congratulations on 15th daily reward and first 14 times on SW's side. Let's stop hitting my cable with that. Within this, we got to be able to create an assignment that gets common formats and uses the dot intersection method, which takes in two arguments, formats one and formats two. Those are list, yes, but also the weird stuff. Okay, so we need to return a set. Okay, how do we use the intersection method? I'm gonna switch up the music. There we go. So I'm assuming if I do return set, that should work. So do I have to do format one dot? Okay. Thank you for the Gandalf. Okay. So I need to... this. There we go. Thank you for the hydrate. Okay. Let's see how they did it. Oh, I didn't need the third set. So I was making one extra call than actually needed. Okay, Waffle. Have a good day. Okay. Don't edit above this line. The assignment is we got to complete pair documents with a format function. Takes two lists as the input, doc's name and doc format. Each contains a string. Doc name is... Okay, so we would do... writing from PHP to this is a little bit, like, messing with my head. I can close out that for now. So for this, we want to create, let's do zip, which is equal to array, because we just want an array of tuples. Where we want... actually, let's do... I need to get rid of caps lock. We'll do... for I in... range. Zero onto that. Okay, so it should be zipped up. Okay, so we got that. Next, filter the list of the tuples. to only include the tuples where the format is one of the given valid formats. Okay, so then it'll be for... I mean, I could do 2 and 1 rather than having it split up in them. I could do if... in... then we append the tuple to the list. And then return zip. There we go. Let's see their solution. Oh, zip is a function. Okay, so we need a map. I want to see. Am I even doing this correctly? Let's look at the map function. Python's docs look such a pain. Yeah, so this would be x.upper. I just want to print this. Why is map churning out? Yeah, the function in the iterable. Lambda. Why am I getting an object? Do I need to convert this to a list? Okay, so if I pass in, it's going to print out Fobel Aluminum Yearbook. Okay. Filter out documents. We want to do this. I'm thinking I probably don't need this. That'll be fun. Okay, how does the filter work? Function is my website going down? That's only that one. That makes no sense. Okay, so do I just need to return as a set? Okay. makes no sense. Why is the website down? Welcome in, Hank. How are you doing? Good to see you back. It's all good. I'm sure you'll be able to get through it. Ooh, nice. I had advanced aquatics like first thing in the morning. Okay, that's weird. I wonder why. Algebra is pretty fun. I always found it easy. Sorry, I was looking at my website, this one, which runs a lot of stuff. It was having issues, and I needed to be able to track down what exactly was going on. I can look at certain things and let's see. No errors. Do you have any like cool like electives that you have? Just any ones in general that, like, for me, they didn't have like a lot of computer science or like programming ones, which is like stuff I enjoy. And I've taught myself how to be able to program. Do I have anything like that? Because like I did mechanics, metals, pottery, drawing, digital photography. Trying to think of like extra electives I had. Woods. I got certified as a scuba diver and lifeguard all in one semester. Okay. I'm still trying to be able to think of any. I went to school there for 4 years, so I took guitars once. I had two teachers fired on the job when I was in school. Four classes I was in. That was definitely something. Just a tiny bit. SW. I mean, I was performing on stage in Denver, Colorado. Back when I was like a sophomore in high school for a local rap group too. And that's at the same time when I saw my mom do drugs and nearly pass out and then get kicked out of the concert because she was passing out on the table. Okay, we have a way for doc to sell to their users to support the format. In memory, we store those settings as a simple dictionary. Okay, makes sense. Unfortunately, there is a bug in our code. Okay. Okay, so we're copying the data and then returning the information. When a new format is added and removed, we fix the bug, making add format and remove format pure functions that don't mutate their inputs. So am I just meant to modifying that one and putting it as two. Okay, so I just need to do that with that. I wish I could do Control D in this, like, because in like VS Code, this is a shortcut. Let me open up something. So, like, let's say I updated this bit right here. And if I want to be able to select all of it, I can go through and just take Control D. And it'll go through and select all of them, and I can update them at once. But I can't do that in this. So I have to manually select it and then go copy formats. Should be, yeah, easier to debug. Input and output. I'm glad you're including more comments in your code, but it would be nicer if the comments were about your code. No, rude. Or at least a little bit less obscenity filled. You know what? God damn it. How rude of them. All the functions you've written take everything past to them and return unchanged with this comment. Now you deal with this. It's a functional programming thing, avoiding side effects. You avoid all effects. Only way to be sure, definitely. Okay, so it just does title, which is correct. Lower. The convert case. So basically, all you want me to do oh, we're doing I.O. It's run throughout all the project. Definitely. From the user's perspective, a program with no I/O. Does nothing. How rude of you to assume my code does nothing. A no-op is an operation that does nothing. Rude. Yeah, so it's modifying the scope in the global. So am I just going to write a function that when this one's called, it's just going to go through each line, return it to here, and then so on? It doesn't want to return. I mean, I was going to work with that because I was going to go map. Move from line, comma. Should be backticking. So it's separating it by line and then it's returning it into here. And then I'm just going to do map. Should be that backtick in for new line. Okay, so now we're passing from here. Okay, what's strip do? Do I need to return all this? I did mine better. Okay. Word count memo. Okay, that is... Okay, document is inferred as that. It's going to return the number of words. Okay. A memo is a dictionary and the key. I just want to test. What exactly data am I working with here? Okay, I get what's going on there. Let's see how that works. Fuck it, we'll call it twice. God damn it. What do you mean invalid syntax?